heading to Beers and Gears. This is their initial event, actually, at Sugar Creek Brewery. Sugar Creek Brewery, I believe that's what it's called. I don't think it's brewing, but I'll put the link down below. So new group started up a little meet, and it's from 12 to 3, so it's kind of in the afternoon. It doesn't really, you know, mess with any morning meets, which is cool. So we're just gonna head down, see who's around. I'm expecting some high-end cars. I know the guys who run it are kind of in with all the Lambo guys and stuff, so it should be pretty cool. Not really gonna drink, but, you know, definitely walk around the lot, see who's there, see what kind of cars show up. And it's another clear day here. It's just a little chilly. I think it's like, I don't have my temperature up on my screen here, but I want to say it's like low to mid 40s. It is not warm, especially with that breeze, but it is clear, so hopefully we get a good turnout. And I'll bring the camera out there on the lot and see what's around, and do a walk around and see if anything cool shows up. So let's take a look and see who's there. All right, out here, Sugar Creek Brewing. It is brewing, see, on the thing. Yeah, lots of different cars here. Thought it was more of a Euro meet, but it was a good mix, mostly Euro though. So not really any rhyme or reason to the lot, so just gonna kinda walk around. There's not much on that side. Got some American Muscle here, which I appreciate. I got Mustangs too, so I'm cool with that. Ran into John, think F30, snuck up on me there. Got his M2, things looking badass with all the carbon. Hopefully you can hear me okay over the music, they're kinda cranking it out here. But, yep, bunch of different cars. Another Beamer found me there. Looking clean enough, I guess. So, for those who follow me on Instagram, I did have the car for sale, but I just couldn't do it. Couldn't do it. I watched a video that I had with John, the ride along we did, and I can't get rid of it, man. I love that car. So, got other things cooking this year, so more toys are gonna have to wait. We're gonna head out on the road too. That's where some of the badasses are. I mean, look at these cars pulling up here. Don't know if I know them, but yeah. You guys know, if you know me, you know the R8's one of my cars. So, some Lambos. I'm not gonna walk all the way up the street, but RS7s, Camaros, Vets, kind of everything. Another R8. Head back this way. Sorry, I gotta get that again. You know they're my favorites. This white one I think is about to pull out. Might have to see if I can get that exhaust. I'm gonna walk down this way. A little Rolls Royce action. Kind of a crowd around it. Let's see if I can sneak a view from the other side. There's trucks here, but not too bad. Must be nice. But there you go. Work. Hard work pays off, friends. As a Urus. I see Vin Giggs to my right. We'll pan over that way. McLaren. Vinny in the... We'll go say hi to him in a bit. He's hiding in the corner with the Viper. More Lambos. Some Aston's down there. Oh, that GTR. I gotta go look at that. I freaking love that thing. Kind of what made me go test drive one that day, which was a bad idea because now I wanted one. I still want one, but gonna hold off. Gonna hold off. Got some things cooking as far as real estate goes, so priorities in due time, right? But what a pretty car. AMG GTR, beautiful. This might be Dirk's car. I'm not 100% sure. I'll have to walk the lot a little bit. I've kind of just been yapping. For those who know me know I am good at that. So I'll probably have to be social a little bit. Nice GT3 RS. I've seen that car. I've seen these cars around. I know I have. But whew, beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. I think there's a lot of people here who didn't know this was going on, and they're kind of pulling in like, what's happening here? Because the big boys of Charlotte are out for sure, 100%. We're going to walk down that first row too. I believe there's a C63 AMG Black Series. Pretty sure I saw that in the first row. So, a lot of people revving and stuff. Hopefully that doesn't get us kicked out of the spot after the first show. But that's how people roll. There goes the R8. Oh my lord. Don't do that. Don't make me want one. Again. Like last week. And those who also know me know I used to have a CTSV wagon. So, yeah. If you haven't figured it out, my automotive tastes are kind of all over the place. I just like cars. This one is the one I just pulled in. Let's see if I can. Ooh, that's pretty. That is pretty right there. Definitely a beautiful car. That sounded like the caddy. Good lord. All right, let's see what we got here. It's another AMG. That's not the one I was talking about, though. More Lambos and R10. Oh, geez, R8 V10s. Another one here. Man, this show is not good for my impulsivity. That is for sure. There it is. Knew I saw him come in. This thing's a beast all in itself. I'm pretty sure this is Moe's Lambo over here. I mean, McLaren over here. He got rid of the Lambo for this. Pretty sure that's his. Can't see there's many blue 720S's running around. I will have to, like I said, I'm going to have to do a lot walk and see who we can run into. I believe that's the GT2 RS that I was parked behind at the Cars Cappuccino event with the Taycan. So, by the way, that's how I'm pronouncing it, and I'm sticking with it. Excuse me. So, a quick walk in here. Man, oh man. I think most of these are V10s, too. I mean, that's kind of what everybody wants, right, these days. All right. Gonna walk around a little, see who Greg I can run into. Oh, there's Mo there. Yep, he's here. I thought that was his. Good lord. Probably a Mustang, too. Yep. How did I know? I'm a Mustang guy, but sometimes, man, sometimes I just don't know. Rolling around in your $25,000 Mustang in this lot. We call that compensation, people. Don't be that guy. Be a Mustang guy, but don't be that guy. All right, I'm gonna put this down a little bit, enjoy the show, and then probably pick it up in a little bit later. Well, I guess if you've made it this far, you kind of figured out I didn't restart the camera at the show. Honestly, it was a great show. A lot of cars, all the heavy hitters from Charlotte were there. I got a bunch of pictures and stuff, so I'll go through those and see how they came out. But yeah, I just ended up doing some networking and some talking, and kind of what you guys saw was what was there. There was a few other cars that kind of came in and out over the, you know, the time I was there. I was there about, I don't know, maybe an hour and a half or so. So decent amount of cars came in and out from there, but really what you saw was kind of the bulk of what was there. So got to catch up with some people I hadn't seen in a while and see some cool cars. And I mean, all in all, it was a win. You know, I kind of bundled up. I don't know if you could tell on the camera, but bundled up in layers. So I was comfortable. Even though it was a little breezy. But yeah, good event. If they have it in the future, I'll definitely go. I'll probably bring the Supra next time, honestly. You know, when I reached out to some folks, they were like, oh, bring the Beamer, it's a Euro meet. But you saw in the video, there was Mustangs, there was Hellcats, there were Japanese cars, I think there was Miatas there. And so there was kind of a mix of everything. It wasn't just Euro, so which is cool. I mean, honestly, I get Eurofed sponsoring it and everything, and you know, that's their clientele. But yeah, definitely cool to kind of see all makes and models kind of mixing it up there. So I enjoyed it. But yeah, so we're just heading back now. I'm going to go through some of the pictures and just kind of see how everything came out. And I'm not sure what other events we have going on this weekend, but you know, if there's one and I'm going, my camera will be on it. So stay tuned, check it out.